are Katie, Jordan, and Heather, reporting at the Double O Dag news station at Floyd Dryden Middle School. Certain 7th graders chose to do news stories on current Dryden events.
Earlier this week, Katie and I went with the 6th grade checker team to Methodist camp, where they were learning some survival skills. Our news crew went with them. We're here at the Checker Team Survival Camp at Eagle Beach.
I'm Ashley.
I'm Jordan.
And I'm Katie.
Here's them trying to build a fire. Apparently, they didn't do so well.
What are some problems that you've had during this, or are you succeeding in what you're trying to do?
Well, the wind keeps blowing our matches out.
So what are those packets for that you guys are using right here?
Our teacher gave us a survival kit. So
what do they have in them?
They have
shower.
They have the aluminum foil
for signs.
Actually, well, these are for signs. And there's a fuse. I don't know.
No, it's a rope. Helmet line for tying things together.
Same thing.
We call it. We have two band-aids, food, and we have
fire starter.
Very cool. Very cool. So, what are some of the things you guys are looking forward to in this camp thing that you're having?
Learning how to survive in the wilderness.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
I'm looking forward to building a shelter.
we're
gonna do that.
Yeah,
that's kind of what I'm looking forward to, is the shelter building and just
hiking in general.
Cool. Oh, you guys have Jolly Ranchers in your bag.
A pick-me-up. Like, you're out there and if you start feeling down, it's there to, like, pick you up, give you a little boost of energy.
How do you make a fire?
Well, pretty much. You've got to find a nice place away from the wind. So, and you want to make sure that you don't have any other stuff around it so it'll catch fire and spread. And you want to go find some nice dry wood and break it up into kind of small pieces. And you want some, like, thin, stringy stuff that's really dry like this. That'll, for the starter, so you just light this stuff and it spreads.
Okay.
And yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. Okay, so you're putting the softer stuff in the middle. Is that because it starts easier?
Yeah, it is. It makes it start easier, and then after it burns, it will go, like, it'll burn these ones, and then we can put more woods in it, and sticks, dried sticks, and they'll start burning, and then add more till we're done.
That's cool. Okay, so you guys have been going around for a while trying to find this stuff?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Where do you think is the best place to find dry wood?
Anybody?
That's in the woods.
Woods, like branches that are covered by the trees, so like from the rain, so they're not wet. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Later at the Methodist camp, they will be here doing more survival activities. Signing off,
Katie,
Ashley,
and Jordan.
Bye! What an awesome experience for them. We're very glad they had a chance to learn some survival skills. Over to you, Heather.
Thanks, Jordan. That trip sounded fascinating. For the next story, we're going to tune into our reporter, Elena Brubaker. She is going to go along with 7th grade Floyd Dryden students on a cruise to Tracy Arm. Let's see how it's going.
Elena Brubaker, reporting here in downtown Juneau, the Explorer team is now boarding the Keat. These Floyd Dryden students are preparing to go on a field trip to Tracy Arm. They will be seeing a spectacular glacier and hopefully some wildlife.
Here we are on the Keat. What are you guys expecting to see?
Mountain goats!
Maybe the glacier will have one.
t-shirt.
Hi, I'm Sarah Day, and this is Jesse Richards, one of the teachers on our trip.
Why did you choose students to Tracy Arm?
Well, I thought that so many students don't really get to see exactly how beautiful their backyard is. So we had the opportunity to bring students here just to see how pretty it is and to see how amazing it is that they live in a place like this.
What are you expecting to get from this experience?
Well, I'm hoping that the students really gain an appreciation for just what is in their backyard.
Here we are at the glacier. It's a beautiful sight. There are seals on the icebergs, and we may even see the glacier cap.
Thanks, Heather. It sure looked like you guys had great weather during your trip. For the past 2 weeks, the sixth graders have been studying survival techniques. Living and playing in Southeast Alaska can be a fun yet dangerous situation. Let's see what reporter Katie and her co-host Alicia are up to.
Hi, I'm Katie Willis, here with my co-host Alicia Cox. We're in front of the Augustus Brown Swimming Pool with Floyd Dryden's 6th grade 007 team.
They're here for the cold water safety classes. Let's go inside and see what's happening.
6th graders from Floyd Dryden spent the afternoon at the swimming pool learning cold water safety skills. They were taught by several certified instructors. For the last 2 weeks, these students have been learning different survival skills in their class.
Very important for the kids to know water safety because here in Southeast Alaska, they're often out in the water and doing activities such as fishing or scuba diving or whatever they happen to be out in the water for. So they need to know the basic ways of survival.
The students learn many important survival skills, including how to ride a canoe, the huddle position, and the reach, throw, tow, but don't go method.
What do you think are the most important things you've learned today at this class?
Most likely that we should not go in the water if we're going to try to save someone. It's a reach, throw, but don't go. It's kind of a little rhyme they have. But, yeah, that's probably going to be one of the main things, because you could be a victim if you try to save someone.
At the end of the day, the kids loaded onto the bus that would take them back to Floyd Dryden.
Well, it was a great day here at the swimming pool, and I think all the kids learned a lot.
I agree. For Double O Deg News, I'm Katie Willis, signing off.
It sounds like basic water safety training is something every Southeast Alaskan should know. Eighth grade graduation is also something students will be experiencing this spring. Glenn?
Thanks, Jesse. The last few weeks of school are always exciting, especially if you are in eighth grade. We go now to the 8th grade halls of Floyd Dryden to see what the 8th graders are looking forward to high school.
Hello, I am in the 8th grade hallway. No longer will the present 8th graders pass through this way. We interviewed a few of them to get their thoughts on this event.
Hello, I'm Karsten Beck and I'm here in the 8th grade hall of Floyd Dryden. I'm here with Cody. Cody, I have some questions to ask you. What are you looking forward to in high school?
I'm looking forward to the world language classes because I'd like to go to Japan and, of course, knowing Japanese would help.
Of course. Do you have any advice for the 7th graders soon becoming 8th graders?
Don't get behind on your work. Trust me, it'll really come back to bite you if you, like, let your work keep sliding.
Of course. Kyle, will you miss Dr. Sue?
Yeah. I've only known her for 1 year, but in that time, I've known that she's a very nice person and that she does a lot of stuff for her students.
That's for sure. We'll miss you, Dr. Sue. Kyle, who's your favorite teacher?
Miss Eiler, by far. She knows her students really well, and she likes them.
I'm here in Miss Eiler's 8th grade room. She teaches history and science. Miss Eiler, will you miss Dr. Sue?
Oh, yes, I've enjoyed having Dr. Sue here very much. However, I'm very pleased to have Mr. Milliron moving into the position.
Miss Eiler, will you miss your students? After all, they are graduating from middle school.
Yeah, I always miss my students, but if I'm lucky, then some special ones get to come back and see me, and I really enjoy being with them. They're really great kids, but they're moving on to high school and on to their lives, so hopefully they'll come back and see me, though.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm Karsten Beck, signing out from Miss Eiler's 8th grade room. I'm here with Tyler, another 7th grader. Tyler, what are you looking for in the upcoming 8th grade year?
More teachers, newer teachers, and more opportunities.
Good. Thank you, Tyler. Tyler, also, will you be missing Dr. Sue?
Yes, but I'm also glad that Mr. Milliron is staying with us.
Thank you, Tyler. I'm here with Janelle, another 7th grader. Janelle, will you be missing Dr. Sue?
Yeah.
Me too. Janelle, will you miss the 8th graders going on to high school?
Of course. They're very cool and nice.
I'm here with John, another 7th grader. John, will you be missing Dr. Sue?
Yeah.
What will you miss most about her?
Her being like a good principal and stuff, and I've never really had a girl principal before.
Do you think Tom Milliron will be another good principal?
Yeah, he's done a good job with the discipline plan. I think he'll be a good principal, too.
What are you looking for in the upcoming 8th grade years?
Probably graduating and going to high school.
Same here.
We sure will be missing Dr. Sue and the 8th graders. However, we are looking forward to becoming 8th graders ourselves next year. Let's head over to our downtown center with our sports report.
Thanks, Glenn. Next up, we have the Floyd Dryden vs. DZ soccer game. So far this season, we have had 3 games. DZ won the first 2 with 3-2 and 6-4 wins. The most recent game was won by Floyd Dryden, 4-2. Let's now go to Matt and Craig, who covered Wednesday night's game at Adair Kennedy Memorial Park.
Who do you think is going to win this game and why?
I think that DZ is going to win this game.
That's right.
Because all of our team members are gone.
Uh-huh.
And they're loaded.
Yeah, that's right. DZ is going to win. They're loaded.
What reasons do you have to think you will play bad?
We had a game against the high school a while ago, and I used up all my energy then.
What do you think of that kid that jumped up and hit the ball with his hand in the first game?
I think that was very bad. He shouldn't be playing today because that cost us the game, and we could have won. I'm very angry with him, and I don't think he should play. I've said.
Throughout the game, we played exceptional defense, holding their offense to only 2 goals. We took many shots on goal. Watch closely as Evan does the world-renowned loser dance after a beautiful goal scored by Mark. Shown here is an excellent left-footed goal by Danny, putting Dryden ahead 2-0. Over the game, we scored 4 goals. DZ only scored 2.
Hey, I'm standing here with Mark Rainery from the Boys A soccer team. Mark, what position do you play?
Defense.
How are you feeling when you first went into this game, Mark?
I was a bit confused because I normally don't play defense, and I was just a bit confused, yeah.
So, Mark, didn't you score in this game?
Yes, I did.
What position were you playing when you scored?
Defense.
So how did you feel when you scored?
I was a bit amazed because I was trying to cross it into the middle for one of our players to have a chance to put the ball in the net, but apparently the goalie wasn't quite ready for that shot, so the ball went towards him, but he was looking more in the middle because that's where he thought it was going. So he kind of hit it into the goal, but it was fine. We got a point.
So, Mark, how does it feel to beat DZ?
Well, the last time that this happened was last year, and I kind of forgot how it felt, but it feels really great.
All right. Thanks, Mark. I think you have a bright future in soccer.
Thanks.
Nice victory dance, Evan. Boy, did we do good. This season we played some great soccer. Well, thank you for watching. This is Matt Brooks, closing out for this week's Sports Report. Take it, Shane.
Thanks, Matt. As a soccer member myself, I know how exciting it can be. Now let's take a look at how exciting school can be. That's right, school can be exciting. Take a 7th grade honors English class, Mrs. Dagner, and give some eager students a video camera, and you get some high-quality video shows. Let's go to Evan.
This month, Mrs. Dagner's 7th grade English class is taking a break from the usual. They're getting a chance to learn some real-world writing skills in the art of TV. Each group has chosen a topic and made a news story out of it. Now, to Shane in the field.
Hi, I'm Shane Gutnick, and I'm here in the BP lab of Floyd Dryden Middle School as Mrs. Dagner's Honors English class is diligently working on their video shows. First they filmed, and now that they have done the filming, they're editing their hard work. The articles are from as near as Floyd Dryden and as far as Tracy Arm. When done, the movies will flow very smoothly to hide the massive amount of work put into them. Let's ask some of the students how they feel about their project.
Well, I think this project's a fun project, but one reason I don't like it is there's not a lot of acting. There's a lot of filming other people, but you don't actually get to act in it, but I think it's a good project.
It's pretty fun, get to be on TV.
I think that it's cool because we get to work on the computer and with video cameras, which is fun.
It was okay. I think the mystery movies were better, though.
This one's a lot funner, other than the movies that we made earlier in the year. And it's just been a lot of fun because now I might have an advantage of getting like a news career job later.
I think so far the project's had its ups and downs. I think next year when I do the project, I will allow students more time. But I think also the stiff deadline allows students to work under pressure, which is what you have to do in the real world.
Well, it looks like we got our story done in time. It sure was nice to have the cooperation of students and teachers. Hey, Justin, didn't you do a story on student-teacher relations?
Yes, we did. In school, students and teachers always have something to argue over, whether it's grades or just the way they're acting. Well, we've sent one of our news teams to go and find out what just causes the friction between students and teachers.
Hi, I'm Blaze Roloff, here today at Floyd Dryden Middle School. We've interviewed some students and teachers here at Floyd about student-teacher relationships. Let's hear what they have to say.
Do you deserve detention when you get it?
I would say no, because I never really do anything that deserves detention.
What causes friction between teachers and students, and what can we do to help it?
What causes friction between me and teachers is when they do something that I don't think is fair, and they don't really give me a chance to speak.
Okay.
How have rules changed since you were in school?
They used to paddle. I won't tell you if I got a spanking myself. I did. But in middle school, they used the paddle when I was in middle school.
Why do you dislike certain teachers? No specific names.
I don't like how some teachers don't, like, respect you or, like, believe you when you tell them something.
Do you feel that most kids are troublemakers? And if so, why?
No, I don't think by nature most kids are troublemakers, but they do what feels natural and best, and sometimes that isn't always comfortable to the adults.
Do you feel that you're a strict or a nice teacher?
I think I'm probably in the middle. I think there are times when you need to be very strict, and there are times when you need to be nice, too.
What causes friction between teachers and students?
I think oftentimes friction is caused by a lack of communication or misunderstandings, and some people, students and teachers, may jump to conclusions that the other party doesn't recognize as the reality of the situation. So really probably misunderstandings and lack of communication.
Well, there we've heard their opinions. This is Play's Rollout reporting live from Floyd Dryden.
I hope that all the students and teachers watching this have learned what they can do to make their student-teacher relationship a respectful and healthy one.
And now, thanks for watching our first news program. It's been a lot of fun making it, and we hoped you had a lot of fun watching it, too. Now, this is Evan and Justin signing off. Good night.
All right.